Hi and welcome Atelier Marie Kunik podcast, a podcast about knitting, sewing, embroidery. So if you're interested, keep watching. Hi, welcome. It's November 28th and it's the sixth podcast of 2022. And in this podcast I will mostly talk about knitting. I haven't done a lot of sewing and I have done some stitching, but I don't have a lot of time because my husband is at home and he doesn't want to be upstairs for all too long, so I want to keep it a bit short this week. So grab a drink and let's get started. Let's get started with what I'm wearing. And this is a very old one with a lot of problems, I might say. It's the Elfin cardigan and it's a cardigan I knitted in back in 2003. From this Rowan magazine, and it's, do I know where the, yeah, here it is. So here's the Rowan version, and I believe I used the same yarn they used, although mine looks a little bit more purplish. Anyway, I have worn this cardigan a lot, really a lot. So it's got a bit of a problem at the moment and I have to mend it. As you can see here, it's got lots of ruffles, but as you can see in my there are holes in my sleeve, and as you can see there also are some problems with the ruffles. Not only here, but here as well. I hope you can see it. Anyway, I do have some of the kit silk haze I used for this project, but I don't have the yarn anymore. So I am thinking of doing some visible mending on the sleeve using some other yarns. Because, yeah, I love the cardigan. I love the ruffles. I simply love this cardigan. So I have to mend it. The problem with the sleeves are they are a bit wide, as you can see. But, yeah, I hope I can recover some of the ruffles and make some new, knit some new in between. So I can keep on wearing this weather. And maybe if I can't do that, I might adjust the sleeves. So I can at least wear this cardigan a bit more, a bit longer. But let's see if I can save it first. So we are talking about knitting, so let's move on to what I am knitting on. And I am still working on my Felix sweater. I showed you last week. I finished the sleeves and I'm now knitting on the body. But I ran out of yarn, so I had to buy some yarn before I can move on with this sweater, and I did so this weekend. This weekend I went to Amsterdam to the Afstap. That's the yarn shop that sells the Rowan kid silk haze. I visited Hooks and Yarns as well because I wanted to see how that what a yarn shop looked like. I'd never been there before, so I decided to go by train to Amsterdam, visit Hooks and Yarns first, and then move on to the Afstap to buy my kid silk haze, and so I did. So I will show you a little bit of the footage of both the shops now, so you can see how they look like. Okay, so that's what the yarn shops look like in Amsterdam. And of course I bought some kid silk haze to knit on my sweater. Not on my sweater, on my cardigan. But this week I knitted on something else a lot. And so none of my recent projects got any attention from me. So the reason why I haven't knit a lot on my other project is because, well, a colleague of mine is going through a very rough time. And she's going to lose her husband. And I thought I wanted to support her a bit by giving her a care package for herself. And I decided one of the things I wanted to put in that package is a some socks. And I had a ball of Bergère de France Gloomy 50. Excuse me for the ball label, because it's a very old one, so it doesn't look very well. It's this color. It's a gray. But since I don't have... I only have one ball, I decided to make scrappy socks for her instead. So this weekend I have been knitting like crazy. And here's my process so far. So I added all kinds of other colors to go with it. And I already knitted both leg parts. And I knitted both heels. And now I'm moving on to the foot. And that's my priority knitting for the moment. I am using Hermione's Everyday Sock. I believe it's the pattern is called. And as you can see, it's a bit of a small, yeah, how do you say it? It's a free pattern on Ravelry, so I will link it below. But as you can see, it's a row of knitting and a row of knit 3 and purl 1, and then alternated every other row. And that's why you get this lovely fabric. And it's one of my most favorite patterns, I must say, because it's a lovely way of knitting. And while I am showing you this sock, I am remembering I wanted to tell you also a little tip. And I have to get something because I wrote it down on a little piece of paper. I watched the Wool Needles Hands podcast by Taylor. And Taylor had a... this week Taylor had a great tip about knitting stripes in ribbon and how you can avoid to get those bumps in between. So you will get, as you can see here are a few bumps below the actual stripe. And she told about a tip. You can avoid that and get a clean line, and avoiding it this is by knitting one row, knitting straight, and then go on with your ribbing. And I thought, duh, why didn't think I never thought of that, because I knitted a lot of striped socks, and I also knitted striping in the ribbing, and that always was something I thought, well, wouldn't it be nice if it could be a clean line? And now I know why. So what to do to get such a nice line. So if I didn't explain it very well, please visit hers so you know what to do if you want to knit stripy ribbing. So those are the projects I am knitting on right now. So the last thing I would like to talk about is the my swap and my Happy Scrappy sock blanket, because they are linked, as you might well know. My swap is all about receiving some sock yarn for my advent calendar. So if you want to join, you are supposed to send me about 20 grams of sock yarn, either commercial or hand dyed. And in return, you will receive some of my one of my stitch markers. And I have a few left. So let me show you which one I still have. This one. The black one. I hope he, maybe I should show them. This little one. In an earlier podcast, I talked a bit more about my the way I made the beads, because the beads I made myself as well, the glass beads. And these are the ones that still are available. So if you want to, okay, please would you, I would like, yeah. It's always a bit difficult because he wants to focus on my, on me instead of on my stitch markers. So those are the ones I still have available. And if you are interested in swapping, you're supposed to send me 20 grams of sock yarn. You can contact me either on Instagram via PM, or I will put down here my email address so you can send me an email as well. 20 grams of sock yarn, and I would like you to make it into a nice package so I can put it in my advent calendar. And in return, I will send you one of my stitch markers. So that's about the swap. So let me show you my blanket. No, I'm going to leave the, I have a little ball with yarn. This is my blanket, and as you can see, I only added two this week. Simply because all my knitting time went into the socks. And I like the way this blanket will turn out. So this is it this week. As I mentioned, most of my knitting time went into the socks, and I did some stitching, but not noticeable enough to show you. I still am working on my advent calendar bags, so I will show those next week, I believe. Oh yeah, I also wanted to talk about Vlogmas. I was wondering would or wouldn't I do Vlogmas this year, and I've decided to not do a normal Vlogmas, but I will share unpacking my advent calendar in a bit of a Vlogmas style. So, and I will put it in my normal podcast. So hopefully you will get a bit of an idea. But doing a whole Vlogmas, Vlogmas every day was simply too much for me this year. So I will share some things related to Christmas and my advent calendar, but I will not do a whole Vlogmas. So I hope that will be wonderful as well. Anyway, this is it. Everything I talked about will be listed below in the description box. If you like the episode, please give it a thumbs up and to give it a bit of a rising up in the YouTube world. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do so. And hit the notification bell, then you will see a message whenever I upload a new video. I enjoyed even having a small episode and talking about what I've done this week. So I hope you did as well. And I hope to see you next time. Bye.